September 22nd, two counterfeit $50 bills was passed at a local business. Through the investigation of those two subjects were identified, and on September 25th, multiple search warrants were issued for a local motel in Dothan and the suspect's residence. During the search of the motel room, several items were seized related to this counterfeit process they were conducting. Four subjects were arrested in conjunction with the investigation. Travis Eggert, 28 years of age, white male, Cottonwood, charged with possession of a forged instrument. First, $130,000 bond. Devin Michael Little, 32 years of age, white male of Dothan, charged one count forged reverse. Ashley Samantha Gray, 26 years of age, charged with possession of forged instrument first and forgery first. And Corey Lee Flowers, 32 years of age, from Cowards, charged with one count of forgery first. This type of information we received on this was, like I said, it was a couple bad 50s passed. The process they were doing was bleaching the money. You take standard low denominated bills, bleach them, and then reprint them into a higher number, higher bill, as you would say. In this case, it was some 50s and 20s. And a lot of times you'll use these pens to strike it, and all that pen is telling you is that this is the paperwork, the paper that's used in U.S. currency. That's all it's going to tell you. A lot of times you can look at the larger 5 and up bills. Normally we'll have a watermark in the right corner, the right middle of the face of the bill, that should match the president that's on the bill. And if you look close on some of the ones that we did recover, of course there's not a facial watermark because they were bleaching $1 bills, turning them into 20s and 50s. They've gone through a lot of trouble on this, but they came out with pretty good bills. And we may additionally seek federal prosecution on it. We'll know more on that in about a week.